sending confusion into the camp of the enemy, because the enemy will attempt to keep you from your destiny and to steal your glory. As you send confusion to the camp of the enemy, you will be moving into your calling with greater speed, with greater provision, with greater opportunities, greater favor, greater grace, and greater sight. Where the enemy has attempted to keep you from your glory is actually working for your good, because you've been drawn closer to God for your survival. So these attacks have actually added to your heavenly increases, as the Lord gives you more than you had before. Sometimes the enemy that is against you are coming from your friends and your families, people you have shared personal information with. Psalm 55 verse 9 through 15 tells us, "Confuse the speech of my enemy, O Lord. I see violence and riots in the city, surrounding it day and night, filling it with crime and trouble. There is destruction everywhere. The streets are full of oppression and fraud. If it were an enemy making fun of me, I could endure it. If it were an opponent boasting over me, I could hide myself from him. But it is you, my companion, my colleague and close friend. We had intimate talks with each other and worshiped together in the temple. May my enemies die before their time. May they go down alive into the world of the dead. Evil is in their homes and in their hearts." And in Exodus 23 verse 27, the Bible says, "I will send my terror before you and will throw into confusion all the people against whom you shall come. And I will make your enemies turn their backs to you." Philippians 1 verse 28 to 30. "Don't be afraid of your enemies. Always be courageous. And this will prove to them that they will lose and that you will win, because it is God who gives you the victory. For you have been given the privilege for serving Christ, not only by believing in him, but also by suffering for him. Now you can take part with me in the battle. It is the same battle you saw me fighting in the past, as you hear the one I am fighting still." It is critical to understand that a fierce battle between light and darkness is taking place in the heavenlies at all hours of the day and night. And because our Lord Jesus Christ won the victory over Satan for us on the cross of Calvary, we must rise up to resist every act of sabotage from the enemy's camp. The devil is the accuser of the brethren, a thief, a spoiler, a destroyer of progress, a delayer of miracles, and through his evil activities, he wants to keep you away from your blessings and keep your blessings away from you. But the scripture says, "Evil will cause the death of the wicked, and those who hate the righteous will be held guilty and will be condemned." Psalm 34 verse 21. So don't be scared. Continue to move forward and wage war in your prayer and worship, for you are increasing. What the enemy intends to harm you, the Lord is delivering you and turning to your advantage. As I pray this prayer tonight, it is the midnight hour, and I am taking the battle to the camp of the enemy to remind him he has already been defeated by the blood of Jesus on Calvary. Let's begin. Psalm 109. "Be not silent, O God of my praise, for wicked and deceitful mouths are open against me, speaking against me with lying tongues. They encircle me with words of hate and attack me without cause. In return for my love they accuse me, but I give myself to prayer. So they reward me evil for good and hatred for my love. Appoint a wicked man against him. Let an accuser stand at his right hand. When he is tried, let him come forth guilty. Let his prayer be counted as sin. May his days be few. May another take his office. May his children be fatherless and his wife a widow. May his children wander about and beg, seeking food far from the ruins they inhabit. May the creditor seize all that he has. May strangers plunder the fruit of his toil. Let there be none to extend kindness to him, nor any to pity his fatherless children. May his prosperity be cut off. May his name be blotted out in the second generation. May the iniquity of his fathers be remembered before the Lord, and let not the sin of his mother be blotted out. Let them be before the Lord continually, that he may cut off the memories of them from the earth. For he did not remember to show kindness, but pursue the poor and needy, and the brokenhearted, to put them to death. He loved to curse. Let curse come upon him. He did not delight in blessings. May it be far from him. He clothed himself with cursing as his coat. May it soak into his body like water, like oil into his bones. May it be like garment that he wraps around him, like a belt that he puts on every day. May this be the reward of my accuser from the Lord of those who speak evil against my life. But you, O God, my Lord, deal on my behalf for your name's sake. Because your steadfast love is good, deliver me. For I am poor and needy, and my heart is shrieking within me. I am gone like a shadow at evening. I am shaking off like a locust. My knees are weak through fasting. My body has become gaunt with no fat. I am an object of scorn to my accusers. When they see me, they wag their heads. Help me, O Lord my God. Save me according to your steadfast love. Let them know that this is your hand. You, O Lord, have done it. Let them curse, but you will bless. They arise and are put to shame, but your servant will be glad. May my accuser be clothed with dishonor. May they be wrapped in their own shame as in a cloak. With my mouth I'll give great thanks to the Lord. I will praise him in the midst of the throng, for he stands at the right hand of the needy one to save him from those who condemn his soul to death. Jeremiah 20 verse 11. For the Lord is with me like a mighty warrior. So my accuser will stumble and I prevail. They will fail and be thoroughly disgraced. Their dishonor will never be forgotten. Psalms 35 verse 1 to 25. Fight my enemies, Lord. Attack my attackers. Shield me and help me. Aim your spear at everyone who hunts me down, but promise to save me. Let all who want to kill me be disgraced and put to shame. Chase away and confuse all who plan to harm me. Send your angels after them and let them be like straw in the wind. Make them run in the dark on a slippery road as your angel chases them. I did them no harm, but they hid a net to trap me, and they dug a deep pit to catch and kill me. Surprise them with disaster. Trap them in their own nets and let them fall and rot in the pits they have dug. I will celebrate and be joyful because you, Lord, have saved me. Every bone in my body will shout. No one is like the Lord. You protect the helpless from those in power. You save the poor and needy from those who hurt them. Liars accused of crimes I know nothing about. They repay evil for good, and I feel all alone. When they were sick, I wore sackcloth and went without food. I truly prayed for them as I would for a friend or a relative. I was in sorrow and mourn as I would for my mother. I have stumbled, and worthless liars I don't even know surround me and sneer. Worthless people make fun and never stop laughing. But all you do is watch. When will you do something? Save me from the attack of those vicious lions. And when your people meet, I will praise and thank you, Lord, in front of them all. Don't let my brutal enemies be glad because of me. They hate me for no reason. Don't let them wink behind my back. They say hurtful things, and they lie to people who want to live in peace. They are quick to accuse me. They say you did it. We saw you ourselves. You see everything, Lord. Please don't keep silence or stay so far away. Fight to defend me, Lord God, and prove that I am right by your standards. Don't let them laugh at me or say to each other, now we've got what we want, we'll gobble him up. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, I ask for you to let all the powers encamping against my goodness and breakthroughs become confused and be scattered in the name of Jesus. Let all the powers of my adversary be rendered impotent in the name of Jesus. Let every evil tongue uttering curses and other evil pronouncement against my life be completely silenced in Jesus' name. I command every evil stronghold and powers housing my right and goodness to be violently overthrown in the mighty name of Jesus. I pursue, overtake, and recover my properties from the hands of spiritual robbers in the name of Jesus. Let every counsel, every plan, every desire, expectation, imagination, any devices and activities of the oppressors against my life be rendered null and void in Jesus' name. I terminate every contract and cancel every evil promissory note kept in satanic files for my sake in Jesus' name. I release myself from the powers and activities of the wasters in the name of Jesus. I refuse to be tossed around by any evil remote control device fashioned to delay my miracles in the name of Jesus. Let all the stronghold of evil summoning of the Spirit receive the fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, teach me to avoid unfriendly foods and unprofitable to discussions. Let all my goodness presently in the prison of the enemy begin to pursue me, to overtake me, as from today, in Jesus' name. Let all strange fire prepared against my life be quenched in the name of Jesus. I command every tongue ensuring destruction against me be condemned in the name of Jesus. Let all the troubles of my Israel be disbanded and confused in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus clean off all unprofitable marks in any department of my life. Let all strange hands that have touched my blood be neutralized in the name of Jesus. I command the spirit that abandons blessing to be bound in the name of Jesus. I receive victory over the host of wickedness surrounding me in the name of Jesus. I stand against dreams, defeats, and its effects in the name of Jesus. Let every spirit attacking me in the form of animals receive the fire of God. I stand against the oppression of the spirit of death in my life in Jesus' name. Let the counsel of the devil against me be destroyed and be frustrated in Jesus' name. I bound the spirit of doubt, the spirit of unbelief, the spirit of fear and traditions in the name of Jesus. Father, destroy every stronghold of the powers of darkness in my family in Jesus' name. Let every problem affecting the brain be neutralized in Jesus' name. Let every evil affecting of ritual killing upon my life by my ancestors be neutralized in Jesus' name. Let all terminal genetic and ancestral sickness be healed tonight in Jesus' name. Lord, gives me power to pursue and overtake the enemy and also to recover my stolen properties. Oh God, let your fire destroy every foundational problem in my life in Jesus' name. Let every link, label, and oppressor be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Every evil pregnancy in my life be aborted in the name of Jesus. Let every dirty hands be removed from the affairs of my life in Jesus' name. Let every effect of evil access to my blood be reversed now in Jesus' name. Let everything done against me under the devil's anointing be neutralized tonight in Jesus' mighty name. All evil vessels dispatched to do me harm shall crash in the name of Jesus. Satanic banks, release my properties in your hands in Jesus' name. I remove my name from the book of untimely death in the name of Jesus. I remove my name from the book of tragedy in Jesus' name. All evil umbrellas preventing heavenly showers from falling upon me be roasted in Jesus' name. Let all evil associations summoned for my sake be scattered tonight in Jesus' name. Let every problem connected to polygamy in my life be nullified in Jesus' name. I command every satanic reinforcement against me to scatter it in the name of Jesus. I cancel evil vows that are affecting me negatively in the name of Jesus. I destroy the clock of the timetable of the enemy for my life in Jesus' name. Lord, reschedule my enemy to useless and harmless assignments tonight. Let every evil device against me be disappointed in Jesus' name. Let the healing power of the Holy Spirit overshadow me. I bind every spirit working against answers to my prayers tonight in Jesus' name. I disarm any power that has made a covenant with the ground, with water, wind about me in the name of Jesus. O Lord, make my life invisible to demonic observers. I bind all evil remote control spirits in the name of Jesus. I withdraw all the bullets and ammunition made available to the enemy in the name of Jesus. I revoke any conscious or unconscious covenant with the spirit of death in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I call on the heavenly surgeon to perform surgical operation when necessary in my life. I refuse to be spiritually amputated in the name of Jesus. I refuse to wage war against myself in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, wake me up from any form of spiritual sleep tonight. All evil seed planted by fear into my life should be uprooted in Jesus' mighty name. Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, let your kingdom be established in every area of my life. I cancel all former negotiations with the devil in Jesus' name. Let all my burial goodness and prosperity receive divine resurrection in Jesus' name. I refuse to turn back at the edge of victory in the name of Jesus. Father, pour out shame on all the powers struggling to put me to shame in the name of Jesus. All drinkers of blood and eaters of flesh turn on themselves in the name of Jesus. Spiritual problem attached to me and my family be nullified in the name of Jesus. O Lord, deliver me from all coldness of heart and weakness of will. O Lord, let my life shine the light of goodness and love. O Lord, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray tonight. Amen.